great to be here today? It's just wonderful. And let me tell you today, if you came to just worship, you missed it. But don't take me wrong. We're here to worship the Lord. He's worthy of our praises and thanksgiving. Okay. But you can do that every day of the week, wherever you are. Matter of fact, I hope you're doing that. All heads are going this way. I hope you're doing that throughout the day. You know, we gather here. I hear these people talking about that, you know, we come and sing for an audience of one. And I admire that because I know they're talking about Jesus Christ. But I got to tell you, we are His body. Yes. And the reason we meet together is for one another. Yes. Talk to me. Yes. We're here to collectively worship the Lord and lift our praises to Him. Because He inhabits our praises and He reveals Himself among His people. But if you're not here for somebody else, if you're not here to minister, if you're not here to lift up and encourage somebody else, what are you doing here? All right. Unless the Lord's drawing you and calling you. That's marvelous. I'm just trying to lay the chop. I know I say this 40 Sundays out of 52 out of every year, but you're going to hear me say it. And when 2014 gets here, if the Lord tarries, I'll say it again. Okay, because the body of Christ has got to be ministering to the body of Christ. We've got to be lifting up one another, encouraging one another, and so much the more as we see the day of the Lord approaching. Isn't that good? That's the word of the Lord. We've got to be doing that. And as our brother William prayed, you know, there are people here that's got needs and heart. Some got heavy hearts. Some got their hearts lifted and unloaded. That's marvelous. We're here to lift up and equip the saints and encourage the folks of God and exhort you to keep on keeping on. It's not my day to preach, but I don't care.
Good preaching.
Let me add my word of welcome to everyone who's here. We're so glad you're here today and in the house of the Lord on this Lord's Day. A couple of announcements to add to what Pastor Dennis has said, and that is that tonight at 6 o'clock we're going to meet here for prayer, and if you don't think it's an hour to pray, it's time to pray. And so tonight at 6 o'clock we'll gather here for prayer. And Wayne? And Steve Osborne is going to be here from Love the Child, who's in Guatemala down there. You'll never forget Steve once you meet him. And that's going to be on the 24th of April, on a Wednesday night. He's going to be here. Pete will again resume. Pete and Ron are out of town today, but he'll be resuming his teaching on Wednesday night. So hope he'll be here for that as well. Now, tonight, 6 o'clock. Everyone say 6 o'clock.
6 o'clock.
6 o'clock. Love to pray. Say love to pray. And then if you signed up last week, didn't Brother Walt do such an outstanding job last Sunday on our mission together? Thank you for what you gave for them. Look, either Saturday coming up or Sunday coming up next weekend, and it depends on all you ladies who signed up to be pen pals. We can either do the training at like Sunday night at 5 o'clock, an hour before the prayer meeting, or we can do it sometime Saturday. I just have to hear from you like right now.
Sunday.
I hear that vote. If you signed up to be a pen pal, Brother Walt will be here. Brother Valentine will be here 5 o'clock Sunday night, a week from today, to give you the training. Yes.
Several did not get to sign up last week because they were unable to be here.
Yes.
They can still sign up, and you said they just need to come to the meeting.
Just need to come to the meeting. Okay, 5 o'clock you can be here and sign up then and become a pen pal. Ministering to these gals who are in the Department of Youth Services, who are in these various youth detention centers and prisons across the state. What an outstanding ministry. And so you can still join next Sunday night at 5 o'clock. Yes, Jenny, do you have a question?
I was just going to mention that I am going to have the art show next Sunday at 4, but we should be out. But can we do it downstairs?
Yes.
Perfect.
Yes. Art show's at 4. Oh, this place will be loaded with beautiful art next Sunday. And so don't forget that. That's April 27th. What's next Sunday? What's today? 28th. All right. One other commercial, and what is it? Oh, yes. Everything, the Hispanic church will be in, they're already in revival, I just tell you. From the prayer meetings I've been and all that's been going on, the Spanish church will be having their revival meeting here. But there'll be, this place will be full. You'll probably be able to find a seat. There are other churches are coming in with them, and I just know God's going to pour out. Of course, they want us to come. You're invited to be here and get in on it. And what is it? Friday night.
Next week.
Yes, Friday night, Saturday, and then Sunday afternoon to be here. So it's going to be a full day around here. Yes. Most everyone in them can speak English, and now the pastor is from Columbia, but he pastors at Vestavia Hills, will be speaking. And so I'll talk to Pastor Noel about that.
It's,
yes. That'd be all right. I'll talk to Pastor Noel about that. Look, what God does here affects them. And what God does in their congregation affects us. And so anyway, they'll be fasting, beginning their church is fasting all day Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. And so be much in prayer for the meetings and revivals that's coming up with the Avia Memento congregation that meets here. All right, I know there's more commercials. We'll let them go later. But what we're going to let you do now is have an opportunity to give unto the Lord and to the house and just thank you for your faithfulness in giving and all that God wants to do with that. And while that's going on, the Trimble clan is here. Well, not all of them. Most of them's here. And just glad to have Leah back at town. Hey, she was in an accident yesterday. God just took care of her. Isn't that awesome? Glad to have Seth and Brittany here. And I don't think they knew about singing today, but
yeah, we did.
I did.
And did you? Because Brittany's off the hook.
I got a text last
night. But during the offering, the Trimble clan's going to come and sing. And I'll take you back a little while. But have a couple of men, a couple of guys will come. The blessed the offering plates are here. And but while they're coming, yes, young men, come on, thank you. And while they're coming, let me remind you that all the gifts so far that have been given have gone to the Pen Pal Ministry and Walt Malvin and all that. From this point on, and all through the month of May, where all of our extra mission gifts are going to go to the young people.
Amen.
They're going to be having yard sale. They're going to be having fundraisers during the month of May. We're going to invest our lives in teenagers. Okay? Every extra gift you give, I hope you give it. And from this point on, it's going to go to the young peoples. Okay? We thank God for what He's working among them and what He's doing in them. And we're going to support and help them and urge them on. And we want to see God even save some other young people. Amen? God's adding to the group, and it's very exciting to me about that. And so, let's stand to our feet, and while you're standing, prepare to give, and then Dad and the family can come on, and we're going to sing during this time, all right? Heavenly Father, we thank you today for the privilege of worshiping you with our gifts, Father, from our heart, Lord, unto you. Lord, we're giving it as unto you, and Lord, we thank you for supplying the need of the ministry, this house, this congregation, and the missions we support for the furtherance of the gospel, for the advancement of the glory of God. We love you, Father, today. We bless you in Jesus' name. And all God's people said,
amen.
Amen. You can be seated. All right, Trimbles. There's the big one right there. All right. And we're even getting Alan the Canadian in on this.
Blessings He's given. Even yesterday, I really wasn't going to say anything about it, actually, but the Lord just protected me, and I just give Him praise for that. And He's worked out, and He's already worked it out. I've already got an appointment to take my car and all this stuff. But not even that, but just little things. Like, I lost my stethoscope, and was going to have to buy a new one because I've been going to different floors at the new hospital I'm working at. And I was just kind of bummed about it. I wanted to just like toy stethoscope basically. And I was just like, Lord, you know, would you please, you know, just help me find it. I went to the floor, I looked, I couldn't find it, went back the next day, found my stethoscope. And I was just the little things, you know, the Lord really cares about us and the little things. And I'm just thankful. He, you know, I could go on, I could keep telling all the things that he's done, but I'll give you all the boring details. But I just want to tell you today how thankful I am, because the Lord is so, so, so good. Even in the bad things, he's so good.
I just sometimes I get overwhelmed about it when I think about how good it is and what a blessing it is to have this family. And I know that I don't want it to be something that we take for granted, because I know that a lot of people don't have this. But I cherish this family and just being able to have the encouragement that they give to us, and just what they've given all along in our lives. But I also want to thank each of you that came last night to help out with Aaron's staff. Could not have done it without you. But it's so amazing, because I was a little worried about if we were going to have enough people, because I knew that we were going to have more clients than we had ever had before. And it was so cool, because Tim and I were just trying to get everything ready. We were rushing around doing stuff, and people started coming through the door, and I didn't even know who they were. And I was like, I looked at him and I said, hey, who are these people? He was like, I don't know. God just sent them to us, and they did an incredible job, and I just hope that they'll continue to volunteer with us. But it's just exciting, because when you don't know where it's coming from or how it's going to happen, God does it. And he just provides people, and he sends the troops to help alongside. And so I want to praise him for that, and thank him for it.
45 children.
I know.
37 volunteers. I think y'all put your hands together.
When I got there, I told Rhoda, I was like, oh my gosh, we're not going to have enough food, all these people. And I want you to know, it was the fishes and the loaves, those two pots we had, they didn't even get halfway empty the whole time. It was like they just stayed the same.
Hey,
I'm not afraid.
Thank you.